Hello, welcome to this video. Today we are going to talk about Greylock. We have to perform 5 tasks in Greylock. So this one is for our first assignment of network security. And for a start, we are going to talk about what is Greylock. Greylock is a free source, free software for monitoring networks and systems. So if you want to download Greylock, you can go to the website. And now we are in my desktop now. And to begin, I'm going to introduce you the tasks that we are going to perform in Greylock. The first one is monitoring, second one searching, third one is download features in the marketplace, the fourth one is reporting, and the last one will be content backup. So I will introduce you to the material that we are using. We are using Kali Linux Live, a user, and this one is our server. You can download the package for virtual machines in the website. So if we go here, so this one is the package on the virtual machine. If I click config, see here, it will tell you the IP address. And this one is our Kali Linux machine. So we are going to monitor the logs for Kali Linux. So to start our first task is monitoring. So what we are going to do is just monitor the logs of Kali Linux. So we are going to put logger. I'm going to put baby right here, and here you will see the message. You will see which user is coming from. In this case, it's root. Then you will see the message, and it will tell you the time and the day. So how can this tool can be useful in the real place? Well, it's simple. If you want to see what your staff or users are doing in the real time, so you just can go and just monitor what the users are doing. So for example, if I type again, logger 2. And now we're going to click here update. See, you will see again the message, Mario 2. So the second task that we can perform with Greylock is the tool of search. So if I tap here, Mario 2, if we click here, it will look for the message. So if we click here, we can see that Greylock already found our message that we were looking for. So how can this tool be useful in the real place? Well, if you want to see what the user has been doing and you want to check, for example, if a user has been logging in Facebook, you can go to the user machine and just put Facebook. And it will tell you if the user has been using Facebook or not. So it's a great tool. It's a great tool for monitor what the users are doing. So now we're going with our third task, that is the marketplace. So Greylock is a different software because with Greylock, we can actually upgrade our software. And it's a really easy to download things in Greylock. So for example, I want a tool for DNS. I just go to the Greylock marketplace and I click the DNS. And let's see here. So I click here. So to download things in the Greylock, so just click here. Okay, we're going to save the links as. So, yeah, we're going to save it here. See, it's in document. Just going to put here. And now we are going to our Greylog. We're going to systems. And we are going to content paths. And if we click upload, we check for the file. In this case, it was in documents. And this one is the content. In this case, I'm not able to upload the software because I don't have the database. So to use Greylog in the real world, you need to like set up a couple of licenses. So now because I'm using just the virtual machine, it's not going to allow me to use some of the package. But I just wanted to show you how this one works. So in a real place, it can be really useful. So if you all want to monitor networks, you can download the package of networks, servers, the package of servers, or if you want to monitor some websites or web servers, you can download the package of web servers. So if you compare Greylog with other monitoring system, I found that Greylog is really good because actually you can download the things that you need for your work environment. So, and it's easy and you can upgrade them anytime. So now, the fourth task that we're going to do is reporting. So to that, we're going to here. We're going to reports. And we're going to click here, create report. So because we are only just monitoring the logs of Kali Linux, that is not a big thing. Just I am doing that to show you how actually Greylog is working. So we're going to create just a simple report just to show you how you can do it. I will click here title, report one. And I will put day one. In this one, if you have like networks or servers, you can actually click those things and it will send you the report of the things that you want to know. For example, if you want to know the things about the logs of the network, the logs of the server, so you can just click in those things. But in this case, I will just create a report. Yeah. And now you can see that the report was created successfully. So how this feature can help us in the real world? Well, the first reason is because you want to show your manager that you are doing the work. In the case that you are a network security, you want to have some evidence that you were doing your job. So to have a report in case that something happened, it can help you to show the manager that you were doing the job. So you can create the report daily, though. And as I told you before, you can add more things if you want. In this case, I just put a simple stuff. And as well, you can send this report to your email, or just if you click here, they can tell you if you want the report daily, or you want to send to your email, or the email of your boss, for example. And for example, the report will tell you in graphs, so it will just explain you really good what things are you doing and what things you're not doing. So the report is really a use tool, more if you're working in network security. So now we're going for the last task, that is backup. And this one is one of the most important tasks that maybe every monitoring system should be able to do. So to do the backup, we're going to content packs. And we're going to click here, create content path. Now I'm going to put backup. We're going to put backup one, backup name, summary, everything. I'm going to just carry. And yeah, and here, this one is the most important thing. Here you can see, you can choose which one do you want to pack up. So in this case, just to make it simple, I will just click this one. So I found that these two, I think that is the most important, because if you can back up the monitor system, in case that something happened in your business, in case that blackout, in case of attack, or you think that someone is putting something in the server, you can actually go to your monitoring system and check what's going on. So it's a really use tool. And we're going to click here. Next. Yeah, we're going to click next. And create and download. So what this one is going to do is just create a file that you can just save it, and then you can put it in the computer or in your hard drive, whatever. And then in case that something crash, you not are able to recover the what Grailo was doing, you can go to this file and then upload again, and it will tell you in the time that everything happened, in the time that, for example, the server crashed or went down. So remember the backup in everything is always the most important thing. So here I'm going to save this one, and that's it. So I hope that you like this video. It's only a short video of how to use Grailo. As I told you before, with Grailo, you can do more things. In this case, we were monitoring just the logs of Kali Linux. And it's an easy way to monitor a system or monitor a network. So I hopefully that you enjoyed the video, and thank you so much, and see you soon.